gets the jump. Billy with a problem on the start. He does not get going. Billy cannot get the number 22 started, and we're right back under yellow. Eddie Moran giving the field the green flag. Eric Snow getting a huge jump on the rest of the field as he jumped the gun. Stacy Bolton was bogging the field down. Eddie Moran said, forget it, and he gave him the green. Eric Snow with a surprise jump on that one. He got way out in front with the Dolly's Restaurant number 83. Keep your eyes on the boat video number 12 for Mark Langlois. And here comes Joe Farrell. Farrell won his heat as well. He now runs in the third spot. Billy Beardwood runs in fourth at the number 21. And Bettencourt now runs in the fifth spot. He now looks to the outside of the 65. Matty Moniz and back to the pole man. Oh, Stacy Bolton. Bolton did not get the start. And he threw the green. Down. Eric Snow now run down by Mark Langlois. And Joe Farrell goes right to the outside of Langlois. He looks to make it too wide down the back straightaway. He's trying to get over the second spot. Langlois to the bottom of Eric Snow, number 83. And your new leader as they come by, the low video, New England Recycling, number 12 for Mark Langlois. Here comes.
Langlois trying to pull away. Crushner's out. We've got the 32s.
And now he's back up on the pole. We'll see if he can hold off the charges of the 12 off the fourth front. They come green flag and back up. Eric Snow jumps up.
Bumper tag all the way through the field. Everybody seems to be going. Eric Snow has legged it out a little bit over the number 59 of Farrell. Farrell now sits in the second spot. As you said, he had a great run of the heat, and he now looks second in the feature. Clements have all gone around.
So the third caution of the
eyes on the number five of Tom Furtado and the number 116, last week's feature winner, Jim Silvia. Later in the race, it's when they start making their move. The field is bunched up, green is out. Farrell jumps the green and he gets the lead as they head into 1 and 2.
As they go to 1 and 2, look who's already up to the third groove. Bobby Bettencourt Jr. immediately shot up into that third groove and making work of it. And Tom Furtado, that car sounded sick when he came by.
You just said watch out for Tommy Furtado and a problem with that car as well. The end of the area, number 5. Out in front is the Joe Farrell, number 59. He's about 4 car lengths away from the 12. Here comes the 21 of Bobby Bettencourt.
Langlois trying to hold on a second. Rota Drake to look down underneath, but it looks like the Porsche making up for Farrell, not able to make it back into the pit area under his own power. Two wide action.
for second, but that's all going to go away as the caution comes out. Third, second was heating up severely between Pete Roda, Bobby Bettencourt Jr., and Billy Baird. They were battling three wide around the track for that third, for that second, third, and fourth spot.
Pete Roda are the teeth in the mouth. As you watch them envelop the top two as they come up off of turn number four. Green flag is back up.
Bobby Bettencourt, not one to be afraid, goes right to the outside, right to three wide racing action down the back straightaway.
Well, he knows time is running out with less than eight laps remaining. And like I said, watch these two envelop the leaders. They've already gotten by the 12 of Langlois. Now they've got the 59 of Jim Farrell to deal with.
If Jim Farrell had a mirror right now, he would not like what he sees. He's two of the best street stock drivers around. Now run up on his back bumper. Pete Roda now within striking distance with the number three. Looks to the bottom side.
Well, Farrell got extremely loose off the second road corner. And that allowed Roda to get a run underneath as they run side by side. Bettencourt trying to make it three wide down the back straightaway.
Waves to the field, five laps to go this time, but the tires now may have gone away for Joe Ferro. They seem to be working perfectly for Pete Roda and for Bobby Bettencourt.
Five more times around, 1/3 mile over. Streeter, Peter Roda sets the pace, but he's got a hot Bobby Bettencourt Jr. on his back bumper off the fourth corner. Roda sets the pace, Bettencourt sprints on against Mike Ferro.
Robinson, number 65, pace contact, they go around. Six for Rich Cavallaro. Another accident making contact in there was the 17 of point leader Bobby Rose and last week's feature winner Jim Silvia. They head towards 3 and 4. Green is out. Drag race down to 1 and 2. Roder and Farrell side by side.
Well, here comes 116 and Silvia looking to the outside, trying to make it three wide. Now he threads the needle as Baird would drift up a little bit. That's enough for 4th and 5th. Down the back straightaway. He now shoots to the outside of Bettencourt.
Stacy Bolton begins to bring the number 16 back to the front. Caution is out. Brian Connors missed the number 23 around backwards. Up against the schedule, Jimmy Silvia. He just snuck his way to the top three. He looks down to the bottom outside of Bobby Rose as they head down the back straightaway.
Final time is a 3 and 4. Pete Roda, Bobby Bettencourt. Now Jim Silvia. Bettencourt gets sideways. Here comes Rose to the inside. Roda takes down the win. Second and just too close to fall across the line. 160 to Silvia finishing 4th on the field. But Pete Roda taking down the win. We'll have to wait for the official word for your runner-up.
I can't believe this. 2 wins this year. 2 so far. Unbelievable. Thank you. I don't believe this.
Broke the shifter and wanted to restart. Oh man, it's too much. God. Thing stuck in second gear. Clutch is slipping. Yes. Oh, burning up. Hey, John. Who tightened up the shifter bolt? The rod fell right off and stuck in second gear.
Peter, you just big fuck! Can you sign my head?
Hey, can you sign his head?
Sure, why not?
Oh, yeah! Hey! Okay.
Go, Peter, go!
Keith picking up his second win of the year with the ABC floor covering number 3. Pete, how you doing?
Good. And you, Tiger?
Very good. Peter and I started together. I learned a lot of stuff from Peter, but you taught these guys a lesson tonight.
Yeah, it's never easy, though. You've been out there. You know what it's all about. Man, shifter broke on one of the restarts. Luckily, the car stood in the running gear and we're able to finish, so. But you never know what's gonna happen out there week to week.
This car running perfect almost every week this season. Having a great season so far, too, and thanks as well.
Yeah, I would like to thank Kevin from Vital Wood Products, Westport, ABC Floor Covering, A&R Home Improvements in Fairhaven, Manchester Racing Engines, Westport, and J&S Automotive from Middleborough, Mass, and Jimmy Holmes Alternator and Starters.
Well, you got 2 wins already. You're working around well with the points. It's a good shot at the points.
Yeah, that would be nice. 21 years of doing this, I only got a top 10. Championship be nice, but one race at a time. I want to thank my car owner, Steve Lang, the crew, John Andrews, Dana, Jamie, Kevin, anyone that helps, my girlfriend Sue. I want to thank everybody for this.
All right, we'll let the guys, everybody get in here and get their pictures.
All that work,
right?
Oh yeah, big time.
How
much
work? Thank you.
Peter,
Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter, Peter,